Hello, my name is Mira Ramesh and you are watching the University of Rochester Pathology video series. This video will discuss the basic histology of the ovary. The ovary has three main parts, the cortex, the medulla, and the hilum. The cortex is the outermost layer of the ovary, composed of stroma and developing follicles. The medulla is the middle portion of the ovary, composed of stroma, blood vessels, and nerves. This video will primarily discuss the cortex and the medulla. The hilum is where the blood vessels and nerves enter the parenchyma. The ovaries are covered by a surface epithelium referred to as ovary surface epithelium, or OSE. The OSE is a modified mesothelium which is composed of a delicate single layer of cuboidal to columnar cells. The cortex of the ovary consists of a stroma. The stroma comprises the bulk of ovarian tissue. It contains luteinized stromal cells, decidual cells, smooth muscle, fat, neuroendocrine cells, and endometrial stroma-like cells. The stroma of the cortex also contains ovarian follicles. Each ovarian follicle consists of one oocyte and the surrounding follicular cells. The stages of follicular development are the primordial follicle, the primary follicle, the secondary follicle, and the mature follicle. These stages are shown in the picture on the right. The corpus luteum is formed by fecal and granulosa cells after ovulation has occurred and is characterized by its folded structure. A few hours after ovulation, the fecal and granulosa cells triple in size and start accumulating lutein. On the picture, you can not only see the corpus luteum, but also a follicle. The medulla of the ovary has a stroma composed of fibroblasts, collagen, and elastic fibers. It also contains clusters of blood vessels transgressing from the hilum. The medulla also consists of hilar cells, which are round to polygonal cells presumed to be vestigial remnants of the gonad from its ambisexual phase. Well, that's all for this video. Thank you for watching.